In this video, we're talking about vintage fashion and why I personally think this is the next biggest trend within fashion by far. We're gonna break down why it's the biggest trend, how you can capitalize on this in a really savvy way, and why you need to start archiving your clothes right now. Let's just jump right in. So glad you guys are here for another one of my videos. I missed you so much. And if you're new, hi, welcome to Style Heart. I'm Maytal, so happy to have you. Make sure you subscribe. We have a really good time together. We talk all things fashion, luxury, trends, getting the look for less. You won't regret it. The first thing that I want to discuss with you guys today is why I personally think that vintage fashion is really the next really, really big thing in terms of fashion trends. And the thing is, like, this is not anything new. There are people that live by thrifting, like everything in their closet is thrifted clothing. And specifically with like luxury and designer, a lot of people buy their fashion pieces and handbags pre-owned. I mean, I've bought a lot of things pre-owned. I've always educated myself, and I think I got really good at understanding the pre-owned market, how to navigate it, and how to do it in a really savvy way. The reason I think that vintage fashion, especially within the luxury world, is gonna be the next really big thing is because it's the direction that we're inevitably going in. I mean, more and more people are really conscientious on their carbon footprint and what they can do to wreak less havoc on our very, very fragile environment. The whole world is moving in the direction of sustainability. I mean, especially like the Western world, we're always hearing new companies that are making new efforts towards sustainability. Even some of the biggest fashion brands in the world, mega giants like H&M and Zara, have introduced the Zara Life Collection and H&M Conscious Collection. Now, yes, these are fast fashion companies. A lot of people in the world boycott them altogether because a lot of people believe that fashion should absolutely never, ever, ever be this fast paced. And some of these companies are beginning to feel the pressure and trying to get with the times and adapt with the 2021 consumer. A lot of people have abandoned fast fashion altogether and strictly believe in thrifting clothes or buying clothing with fabrics that were sustainably sourced and sustainably made. I mean, I think there will always be a market for fast fashion because it's affordable and it's accessible and it keeps people on trend without having to spend super high designer luxury prices. Well, that's where a lot of vintage fashion comes in. But with increasing demand and pressure for sustainability within fashion, a lot of people are shifting towards thrifted pre-owned clothes. In fact, the whole vintage thrifted concept has become quite trendy, especially on social media like TikTok. Instead of doing Forever 21 hauls, they're doing thrifted hauls where they get shirts for like $2 and it's like some really cool band t-shirt from like the 70s or 80s. I think as we continue to go forward, as time goes on, more and more people are gonna be moving in this direction. A lot of people just don't wanna contribute to the brutal carbon footprint that the fast fashion industry puts on our environment. There's more demand and more pressure from the consumers, and we're still kind of at the beginning of this trend where it's kind of like just very hip and cool to be thrifty. But I think this is gonna be something that takes over, and not just in terms of like luxury consignment boutiques, which have been a thing for a while now, but just in terms of more thrift shops popping up. Now, again, this is not like a new concept. There's always been thrift stores. I just think this is gonna become more popular and more mainstream where people are like more open-minded to buying used clothing. Because I think like there's a stigma, like a lot of people feel like, oh, I'm not gonna buy used, like I'm not buying old used clothing. That's gross. I think people are gonna slowly abandon that mindset. And I think especially within the luxury fashion community, a lot of people might have this like idea of like a pre-owned handbag or a pre-owned luxury designer clothing. But you know, with these trends, they always start like this, they gain popularity, and then everybody kind of gets on the bandwagon, and that's how it really becomes a big trend. I just really think that the world is going in this direction and fast. And I think it's gonna be not just mainstream, I think it's gonna be the luxury community as well. I think we're all gonna open our minds to this new way of shopping. So now I wanna talk to you about how to capitalize on this trend savvily. Specifically with luxury fashion, this is something that a lot of people don't take advantage of because this is not really something that the typical high-end fashion luxury shopper is buying right now. There's definitely a luxury community that buys a lot of pre-owned clothes. I'm not just talking handbags, I'm talking everything. Shoes, clothing, outerwear, everything. There's always like a fashion deal hunter. I mean, I've like met so many of those in my life where they just have the best scores and they're like, I bought it pre-owned. And I feel like most people are still in that mind frame where especially like the high-end luxury fashion shoppers are not looking for fashion pieces on the resale market. First of all, a lot of high fashion fashionistas want the latest, the most current. But what I think is gonna happen is that it's gonna be all about previous collections. I think that's what's gonna happen. So I honestly think specifically right now, you can really do this in a really savvy way. The prices are not gonna be crazy inflated right now. There's not gonna be bidding wars on items because in this moment, this is not something that is super trendy and super popular. And I think right now is such a good time to take advantage of this because there are so many amazing fashion pieces that you can find from different collections and get them at dirt cheap prices. And if they were really popular fashion collections, they might not be dirt cheap, but they're still a lot cheaper than they're going to be. Trust me, especially like really popular fashion collections. I think those are gonna blow up in the future where it's just gonna be like absolutely impossible to get like certain pieces from previous fashion collections. And if they are for sale, they're gonna be like thousands and thousands and thousands of dollars. So I'm not saying like go spend and blow a ton of money on vintage fashion, but I'm just saying think before you buy your next trendy item. If there's something that's like really hot and trendy right now that you really love, like I don't know, a Bottega cassette bag, for example, think about how much more you can get from previous fashion collections on the resale market. And even like, for example, a hot trend right now, an oversized blazer, a strong shoulder tailored blazer. If you're buying this trend brand new, some of these blazers are like $2,000, $3,000, $4,000, up to like $6,000. I've seen these blazers for thousands and thousands of dollars. You can literally find a vintage Giorgio Armani blazer for like $200. And it's like cut beautifully, made beautifully. I mean, it's a Giorgio Armani. It's a high fashion house. So you are getting like all the benefits of that luxury designer fashion house at the price of like, honestly, a Zara blazer. I mean, Zara is not even that cheap. Like some of these blazers in Canadian dollars are like $200. I would rather get a vintage blazer, go have it dry cleaned, go take it in. And then when you get that vintage score, it's like you've gotten a piece. I mean, you've really gotten a piece. You know, not like something from Zara where, you know, it's fun for the season. And you know, I'm guilty of this too. I definitely do buy things from Zara and incorporate it into my wardrobe. But these are things that are more easily discarded. You don't value them as much because they're not as valuable, you know? Like the example with the Armani blazer. That is something that you're never going to discard. You're never really gonna wanna get rid of because it's Armani. Even if the trend kind of dies out, it's not something you're just gonna put in a donation bin. You're gonna wanna archive it. Leave it in your closet, save it for a rainy day, bust it back out in like 10, 15 years, and it's gonna be like that amazing Armani piece that you still have in your closet. And you know, this brings me to my number three point, why you absolutely need to start archiving your clothes right now. Now, I started doing this well over a year ago where I decided I am not getting rid of my clothes anymore, I am archiving. I used to, you know, I'd buy a hot piece for the season, I'd wear it, I'd enjoy it, and then if I ever got tired of it, I'd either sell it, or if it was something it was like a cheaper fashion item, I'd like put it into the donation pile. But now what I've started doing is I put like boxes in my basement, and I put all my old clothing that I just don't really vibe with anymore, that I don't wear anymore, into these bins, and I label them. So I'll just make a box full of skinny jeans. Like this whole thing is filled with skinny jeans that I don't wear anymore. And this box is dresses and fitted jackets, fitted blazers, like just all these things that maybe I don't wear anymore. I stopped getting rid of them. I stopped selling them. I mean, I definitely do sell things sometimes. If you follow me on Instagram, you'll see I do sell things, but I stopped being so impulsive with getting rid of my things. Now what I do is I put it in my basement in a fashion archived labeled box, and I know that I am gonna bust that stuff out again one day soon. I mean, I think I'm old enough to know now that like all these fashion trends are so cyclical. All the trends from like my childhood are now coming back, like all these 90s fashion trends. Just to give you an example of fashion collections that were really, really popular during their time and then they kind of fell off and nobody cared about them anymore and now are like impossible to get. For example, the Dior Rasta collection. I remember that to some degree. And that was like a very, very big hot collection for Dior. And then it died out and then it almost became like a very old, outdated collection for Dior. If you were wearing Dior Rasta collection 7 years ago, it would kind of look like dated, like a little old school Dior collection. But now that is like extremely, extremely hard to get because fashionistas are now getting into this whole archiving thing and they're busting things out back from those original collections, like those OG fashionistas that had these collections the first time around are now bringing them back out because they've become relevant again within fashion. Kind of like the Louis Vuitton Murakami. I mean, Murakami was like the biggest thing for Louis Vuitton. Like it really made Louis Vuitton super youthful and relevant again within like the young fashion crowd back in those days, early 2000s or something. Again, if we go back 7, 8 to 10 years ago, the Murakami Louis Vuitton bag would have looked very, very old school, outdated. You know, even though it's designer, it still looks dated. Like you could date it back to that era in fashion. But now getting your hands on a Murakami bag, you're spending well over retail, like way, way more than what it ever, first of all, what it ever cost during that time, but even more than what it would cost in the boutique right now if they made it. They're going for a premium. They're super hard to get because they're super, super rare. And that's why so many designers are bringing back old collections, just like the Prada re-edition, the Fendi baguette. All these designers are bringing back those old bags because they were so popular and now they're gaining popularity again. But the good thing about it, like I said previously, is that you can actually capitalize on this right now because some, not all, okay, not like the Dior Rasta, not like the Louis Vuitton Murakami, but a lot of these first edition of these items are still not going for crazy premiums. A lot of people that love fashion, build their fashion collections, are collectors, whether it's of beautiful ready-to-wear pieces or handbags or everything. A lot of people have the mindset of like every season, they kind of sell their old stuff and then they use that money towards getting new stuff for the season. And yeah, that's not a bad way of getting the latest fashion and recouping some of the money you spent on previous fashion collections. I strongly suggest you start archiving some of these pieces, maybe not all, maybe keep one or two pieces from a previous fashion collection you don't really wear anymore. If you have a ton of pieces, maybe keep a third of them because you are gonna like them again. If you're a fashion lover now, chances are in 15 years from now, 20 years from now, you're gonna be a fashion lover still. I know that's a long time and I know it's a little ridiculous to say like you should start keeping your clothes for like 20 years from now. But I'm telling you, this is the direction we are going in. These pieces are gonna be so hard to find. They're gonna be so much cooler and more exclusive than any new collections. And you know, it might not be 20 years from now. Fashion has become so, so fast paced that it almost seems like things that were in fashion, like, I don't know, 5 or 6 years ago are almost coming back again. It's like the weirdest thing, I don't know. Maybe that's just me, but I just feel like it's just so, so fast paced. Usually the cycle is like 20 years, 20 to like 30 years even, but these really are forever pieces. You gotta start somewhere and now is the time. Now is the time. And also, I'm not just saying this for you to keep clothes for like 20 years from now. Honestly, a lot of times I personally have been very trigger happy to get rid of an item. And even just like a year later, I'm like, oh, I wish I didn't get rid of that. That's kind of what really made me start archiving my clothes. And I really think it's the best move for sustainability. It's the best move for like a fashion collector. And it's like major long-term gain. All right, guys, that's all I have for you. This was like, I don't know, kind of a random video. I literally have been thinking about this for a long time. And I just decided today, I didn't really have anything to film. And I was like, I'm just gonna talk about vintage fashion and why I think it's so important, the next big thing in fashion trends. I really hope you enjoyed this video. This is really how I feel about this. I think it's the best move right now. I think it's, you know, something we should all be taking advantage of for all the reasons I mentioned here in this video. As always, I'd love to hear your thoughts. Let me know what you think. I love hearing from you. I love you guys so much, and I'll be back very soon with another fabulous video, and I can't wait to see you. So until next time, bye for now.